Class 10th, let's start today's class.
Turn page number 135, let's start the chapter Natural Vegetation. First of all, we'll learn about or read about natural resources. What are natural resources? So, we know that the human life on earth is possible because of bounties of nature. We are surrounded by different like bounties of nature, you know, and we have soil, water, wildlife, and flora, fauna. All these are the gifts of nature, and together they are called natural resources. So natural vegetation is also one of the natural resources, right? We'll talk about natural vegetation. So natural vegetation is what? Natural vegetation refers to a plant community which has been grown naturally without human aid and has been left undisturbed by humans for a long time. Natural vegetation includes trees, plants, grasses or grass family, right? This natural vegetation of an area is an important component because they provide us a lot of products including food and fibers. So not only this, they also provide shelter and food to the wildlife, wild animals, right? The natural vegetation is in an area is an index of the climatic condition. This line is very important. Just underline. The natural vegetation is in an area is an index. Index means it's a sign of the climatic conditions. Variation in climatic condition will be there. That means if an area is with full of trees or plants, then that naturally the environment or the temperature will be cool of that area, right? But you imagine or you just think that an area with the without natural vegetation, without trees, plants, so the temperature will be very high. So this means that the natural vegetation means trees and plants in an area is an index of the climatic conditions. In another word, we can say that the natural vegetation of an area that plays an important role in modifying the climatic conditions of that area, of that particular area, right? Now next we have the huge or large diversity of flora and fauna. Plants and animals or trees and animals kingdom is due to the following factors. Here are the factors: temperature, sunlight, soil, relief and precipitation. These are the different factors which affect the natural vegetation of a particular area. Like temperature and humidity are the important factors which determine the character and the extent of vegetation. On the slopes of Himalayas and the hills of peninsula above the height of 900 meters, the fall in the temperature affects the types of vegetations and its growth and changes it from tropical to subtropical and temperate and alpine. So in different height or altitude, you'll see different kinds of different types of natural vegetation, trees, right? You take like a shape or size. They differ from each other, right? So the vegetation which is found in desert area is different from the vegetation found in the high altitudes or the tropical or subtropical regions, right? So that is because of temperature and humidity present in that area or region. Now sunlight, the variation in sun's radiant energy at different places and different due to difference in latitude and altitude, season and duration of the day. Due to the abundance of sunlight, trees grow faster in summer. So sunlight in the summer season, sufficient sunlight available, so in the summer season the trees grow faster, as well as they get precipitation also. In the third point, precipitation means rainfall. So precipitation determines the density of vegetation. If you compare the vegetation found in the desert area and in the vegetation found in coastal area, right? So areas of heavy rainfall have more dense vegetation as compared to other areas. Soil also plays an important role to determine the vegetation of an area. So soil is one of the most important factors affecting vegetation. Different types of soil have different vegetation. Changes in soil condition have given rise to peculiar types of vegetation in many areas, such as mangrove forest, swampy and sandy coastal forest. So mangroves forest, they are found in where water is available, and swampy muddy places they are found, and some vegetations are found in muddy and swampy places, and some are found in the sandy coastal regions or forest. Also plays an important, or it is an important factor affecting the vegetation, like relief means plains, plateaus, hills, mountains, or a coastal area, plain area, etc. have different types of vegetation. Now, natural vegetation of India. So in India there are five types of natural vegetation found. Number one is tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, tropical desert and littoral forest, that is mangrove forest, and the mountain vegetation. Now, tropical evergreen forest or the tropical rainforest. Now, the features of tropical evergreen forest or the tropical rainforest. Now, come to the first point. These forests are found in the areas with an annual rainfall of 200 centimeter or more. So these forests are found in those areas where the annual rainfall is 200 centimeters or above. These forests grow in the areas of high temperature and high rainfall. 200 centimeter per year or annually or more than this, that means high rainfall and high temperature. So these forests grow in those areas. In these forests, trees grow very vigorously, reaching heights of 60 meter and above. So they are tall. 60 meter and above height means they are very tall. Tall trees are found. These forests yield hardwood trees, which is used for making quality furniture. So they are or they yield hardwood trees, which is used to make good quality of furniture. Now the areas found: western slopes of Western Ghats, windward side of Western Ghats, Assam, Bengal island groups of Lakshadweep and the Andaman Nicobar Islands, Odisha have this type of forest. What type of forest? Tropical evergreen forest or rainforest. Now, here are the name of the trees found in tropical evergreen forest. They are ebony, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, cinchona, etc. Other important characteristics of this forest type is that a large number of species are found together, which creates difficulty in the commercial use of any particular variety. Now come to the climatic conditions and the features of tropical evergreen forest. So these are rainfall, temperature, these are the climatic conditions, right? So like the climatic conditions for the what are the climatic conditions for the tropical evergreen forest? So we'll write what? These forests are found in the areas where the where rainfall is 200 centimeters or more, with an annual rainfall of 200 centimeters or more are available, right? And second is they are grow in a high temperature areas with high rainfall areas, right? So these are the climatic conditions. Now, these are the features. What are the features? They are tall, right? And the trees grow very vigorously, reaching the height of 60 meter or above, and this yield hardwood trees, and these trees are not easily exploited. Why? Because of dense undergrowth, thick undergrowth. Because we know that due to high due to high rainfall, the trees in that area, in the tropical evergreen trees, are very dense, right? And there are thick undergrowth also, so very it is inaccessible. That place is inaccessible, and the transportations are also not available in that area, right? So difficult to exploit. So these comes in your tropical evergreen forest features. And rainfall temperature, these are your climatic conditions. Clear? Okay, now. Tropical deciduous forest. These forests are a typical type of natural vegetation of monsoon region. That is why tropical deciduous forest is also known as monsoon forest. Point to be noted, tropical deciduous forest is also known as monsoon forest. These are the most extensive forest in India. On the basis of availability of water, these forests are further divided into moist and dry deciduous. So most of the forest found in India is of this type. Which type? Monsoon type, tropical deciduous type. Now these are of two types, moist deciduous. That means the area they are found in the areas of 100 to 200 centimeters of rainfall, and due to longer dry season, the trees in these forests are deciduous. That means they shed their leaves during the dry season. Why they shed their leaves? That because of dry season. Dry season means no rainfall in that season, right? That is why they shed their leaves. So as each of the species has a different time of shedding leaves, the entire trees is not bare. Not bare means the entire forest is not empty at any time. Not bare. Shisham, sandalwood, teak, sal are some of the common forests found there, and other economically important trees are kher, rosewood, shisham, bamboos are also very commonly found, and this vegetation belt covers a vast area of India, like northeastern states, northeast side of India, along the foothills of Himalayas, Jharkhand, West Odishas and Chhattisgarh, and on the eastern slopes of Western Ghats also. Now next is the second type of monsoon forest, dry deciduous. So the rainfall is 70 to 100 centimeter, right? Between 70 to 100 centimeter. These are found in the rainier parts of Peninsular Plateau and the plains of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. So these are the regions where they are found. They are open, these are open stretches. Teak, sal, peepal and neem are some of the important trees. Most of these forests have been cleared for the cultivation and grazing, for animal grazing and for farming. These trees or the dry deciduous forest have been cleared. So, if we talk about the climatic conditions, so the climatic conditions required for the tropical deciduous forest are rainfall 100 to 200 centimeter of rainfall annually, right? Annually you will add here. And second is dry period. They shed their leaves during dry season, dry periods, right? This you will write in the climatic conditions. And when we talk about the features of the tropical deciduous forest, so there you will write they are commercially important and they are easily exploited, right?
And they shed their leaves during dry periods or dry season, and these are the so these are the characteristics or the features of tropical monsoon forest or tropical deciduous forest. Now next is tropical desert. The areas having a rainfall of less than 70 centimeters support this type of vegetation. So tropical deciduous forest, the trees of tropical deciduous trees or the plant or vegetation found in this desert type of tropical desert, they require 70 centimeter or less than 70 centimeter of rainfall, right? And this comes in climatic condition. Now second is the features. So due to lack of moisture, the trees grow here have very small leaves and they support thorns. Thorns means spines. So whatever the tree is found in desert area, they have very small leaves, and that too, that leaves are in the form of thorns. So that thorns is what? Spines. So why the leaves are in the form of thorns? Because of lack of moisture, right? And I think you are well aware of that transpiration. So transpiration means it's a loss of water or moisture from the plants of the leaves. So to protect from that transpirations from that, the leaves are in the form of thorns, right? And due to lack of moisture also. Now the common species found in the tropical deserts are babul, acacia, kikar, and wild palm. And these trees are found only in the areas of moderate rainfall, right? Now some of the trees which are found in the areas of scanty rainfall. Scanty means very less rainfall. So there, what type of vegetations are found? Scrubs, shrubs, and thorny bushes, like cactus, right? Now the main features of thorny forest are that the trees are scattered and have long plant roots penetrating deep into the soil and spreading into a radial pattern in the search of water. Leaves are small and thick to minimize loss of water. As I told you, minimize loss of water means transpirations. To protect from transpiration, leaves are in the form of either in the form of thorns or spines, and leaves are very small, right? And they have a long root also. Why? Because from atmosphere they are not getting rainfall precipitation. That is why they have a long root, so that they can penetrate, they can go deep inside the soil, and from that underground water they can take moisture water, right? So these are the features of thorny forest. Clear? Now the parts of like Rajasthan, Gujarat, parts of Punjab, Haryana, dry parts of Madhya Pradesh and the Deccan Plateau and the rain shadow area of the Western Ghats have this type of vegetations. What type of vegetation? This thorny forest, right? Okay, now next is babul's leaves, bark, pods and the gum have medicinal value. The leaves and the bark are used in the arresting secretions or bleeding. The pods help remove catheral matter. Now the pods of this babul's plant or babul's tree helps to remove the catheral matter. Catheral matter means it's a mucus present in the throat or in the nose or maybe the sinuses. So the gum also, the gum allays any irritations of the skin and soothes the inflamed membranes of the pharynx, alimentary canal and genitourinary organs also, right? It soothes the inflamed or burning irritations, right? Now the bark of babul tree is useful in the treatment of eczema, allergies, any kind of allergies. Not only that, it is also used as an oil. So oil means edible oil, vegetable oil, right? Palm oil. And some of the trees, like we can say the bark of and the seeds of kikar, also a source of tannin. So the various parts of the kikar are useful in the diarrhea also. So diarrhea means it's a watery stool. When there is an when there is stomach infection or kind of infection in the stomach, then watery stool will come out. So that that is a diarrhea. So it helps in the kikar. Seeds and bark help in this helpful in diarrhea, and the leaves and the bark of it's also useful in arresting secretions of bleeding. Also, they arrest this bleeding. Not only that, the timber, the logs of wood also used in a like constructing construction work. Like making furnitures or firework, it is used, right? It is also used, you know, as a fuel wood. Now flowers of are also used for the ornamental purposes also, like, right? So, and the leaf serves as a fodder for goats. It's a food for fodder, means food for animals like goats, and used in a fencing the hedges also, fencing and hedges also, right? Its wood is also used for the paper productions. It is also sometimes used as the gum. Now children, turn page number 137, important trees. Here are the some important trees given, and the associated vegetation it's given here, like ebony. It is of these are ebony, mahogany. These are tropical evergreen forest, right? And cinchona vegetation is tropical evergreen forest. And like this, here are the name of the trees and associated vegetations. Now the characteristics are also given here, and the uses are given here in this chart, right? So what you are going to do is you just go through this chart. This chart is very, very important, and you are going to learn the uses, name of the tree, characteristics and uses, right? So this you are going to learn, right? Okay, this much for today children. We'll continue with the same chapter in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Stay home, be safe, and be in regular touch with your studies. Thank you.